Hi everyone, I'm Emily, and today we are going over the science behind the rubber egg, sometimes called the naked egg, experiment.
What?
For this one, you need raw eggs, a glass, vinegar, and honey. The first thing you want to do is take your glass and fill it just part of the way with vinegar. Next, take your raw egg and very carefully put it in your glass. If you look closely at your egg, you can already see that something is happening here. You can see there are bubbles forming around the shell of the egg. That's the acetic acid in the vinegar reacting with the calcium carbonate in the shell of the egg. That's creating carbon dioxide bubbles all around the shell of the egg. You can see them getting bigger and bigger and bigger, and then eventually they pop off and come up to the top. Now just wait 24 hours. In 24 hours, your egg will look a little bit like this. All right, my egg's been sitting in vinegar for 24 hours. This is what it looks like. Ew. Take out your egg and rinse it under water and just gently rub the rest of the shell off the egg with your thumb. After cleaning off the shell of your egg, it will look a little bit like this. This is a rubber egg or a naked egg, and it is so weird. You can squeeze it a little bit. I mean, this is a raw egg. Look how weird that is. You can even bounce it a little bit. I'm afraid to do it too high because I don't want to break it. But the coolest thing that I'm noticing here is look how much bigger it is than the egg we started with. Which is weird, right? Because we removed the shell of the egg. If anything, you would have thought that maybe it would have gotten smaller, but it's bigger, it's noticeably bigger. So what happened here? Osmosis happened. Osmosis is all about the movement of water through a semi-permeable membrane. Water molecules are so small that they can get through things that other molecules can't, like the membrane of an egg. With osmosis, water likes to transfer from an area of a high concentration of water to an area of a low concentration of water. I like to think of osmosis like this. If you had two adjacent rooms separated by a door that only water molecules could get through, and in one of the rooms there was this raging water party with a ton of water molecules, but in the other room it was kind of a lame party, not that many water molecules. Well, water molecules are super kind and fair, and so a lot of the water molecules from the super rager party would transfer to the other room through the door that only they can get through to balance things out, to balance the parties out. So in our example, the cup of vinegar, which is made mostly of water, was the super rager water party with the high concentration of water molecules. And our egg was the lame party of water molecules with a low concentration of water. So the water molecules came marching in from the vinegar into the egg through the semi-permeable membrane of the egg and stretched that egg out with water molecules. The really cool part is that we can make the water molecules march right back out of the egg by what? Putting it in a solution that's sort of a lame water party, putting it in a solution with a low concentration of water molecules. That's going to be our honey. So after putting this in a glass of honey for just 24 hours, look what you get. The first thing I notice when I look at this cup is look how runny the honey is. This is not what the honey looked like when we put it in. It's incredibly viscous and thick. But here's what it looks like now. It's super runny. This shows that a lot of the water molecules from inside the egg march right back out and into the honey, making the honey more watery. Okay. Look at this. Do we see how much smaller it is? Now it's actually smaller than the original egg. It's like, you can see it's really like wrinkly now. we extracted some of the water that was inside the egg and made it smaller through the power of osmosis. About relative concentrations. So depending on what we put our egg in, we can either add water to our egg and make it bigger or take water away from our egg and make it smaller. And that is the science behind the naked egg experiment.
We're doing a test to see how high we can bounce a rubber egg. Just like an inch off the ground.
Okay.
3 inches off the ground.
Oh my gosh.
5 inches, maybe?
Oh my gosh, you guys.
7 inches.
What?
11 inches.
What?
I had to get measuring tape. 1 foot off the ground. 13 inches off the ground.